Hey you guys, it's Paul here, and today I'm going to show you how to make homemade ginger ale using a ginger bug. Now, did you know that with a ginger bug you can make any type of homemade soda you want? Cola, root beer, cream soda, you can even invent your own. You just add some ginger bug to your sweet drink mix, pour it into a bottle with a tight seal, and in a couple of days it'll be naturally carbonated and packed with really healthy probiotics. Now, if you don't have a ginger bug, you're going to have to make one. Don't worry, it's super easy. This is just ginger, sugar, and water. It does, however, take about a week before you can start using it. Now, if you have a ginger bug in your fridge right now, pull it out, and we have to get it all bubbly and active again. So you do that by feeding it a teaspoon of grated ginger and a teaspoon of sugar. And depending on how warm your kitchen is, you let it sit out for 3 to 8 hours, and you want it to be bubbly on the top and really sweet smelling. Now, is your ginger bug all bubbly and ready to go? Well, keep watching. Here's how you make ginger ale. So here's a list of all the ingredients we'll be needing, and it's really important that the water is dechlorinated. So use bottled water, or if you want to use your tap water, just put it in a container and let it sit out for 24 hours, and the chlorine will just disappear. Put your water into a saucepan and add in your grated ginger and your molasses. And the molasses is going to give your ginger ale a really nice color. Also add in your grated lime zest, and you can also use a lemon for this. You don't have to use a lime. And you want to bring this mixture to a boil, and you have to cook this with the lid on. So make sure when it comes to a boil, you lower the heat enough so that when you put the lid back on, it doesn't boil over on you. Now cook this for about 10 minutes and turn off the heat and add in your sugar, your lime juice, and last but not least, your sea salt. And stir this around for a few minutes just to make sure all that sugar gets really well dissolved. You don't want any traces of sugar left behind in there. Now remove it from the heat, and I like to let this cool for another 10 or 15 minutes or so just to give it more time to steep. And then pass it through a kitchen strainer. You want to discard all the solids in here. So squeeze out as much of the juice as you can. And now I'm going to strain the ginger ale again, only this time I'm going to pass it through a coffee filter. And you can also use cheesecloth to do this, but I am going to warn you, this is going to take a few minutes. You can see how slow the stream is going through here. You see how slow that's going through? But if you don't do this, you'll have all these little bits of ginger and lime still kind of floating in your ginger ale, and you don't want that. So just be patient. This is going to be worth all your effort. So slide your spatula along the bottom of the filter, and eventually it'll all go through. It also helps to rock the strainer back and forth, and I think altogether this took about 7 minutes, so it really wasn't terrible. Okay, now it's time to add our ginger bug, and remember, it has to be nice and fizzy before you do this, or it's not gonna work. Now, I have so much ginger in my ginger bug right now that it's really hard to see, but if you look closely, you can see tiny bubbles rising to the top, and my ginger bug actually hissed at me when I opened it, so if it makes a hissing sound, you know it's ready to go. So I'm going to strain out a quarter cup of the liquid here, and I'm going to discard a lot of these solids because there's so much in there. And your ginger ale has to be cooled completely before you do this, because if it's still too hot, it'll kill the ginger bug and your ginger ale won't carbonate. Now to keep our ginger bug going, we have to feed it again. So give it some more ginger and sugar and dechlorinated water. This doesn't have to be perfectly measured, just enough to top it up. Don't use anything metal to mix it. Ginger bugs don't like metal. And put a really loose lid on it and put it back in the fridge. And if you're not going to use it for a while, feed it more ginger and sugar once a week to keep it active. Now I really like using these glass bottles with the swing top lids to put my ginger ale in, so I'm gonna fill it up, but only 2/3 to 3/4 full, because you have to allow room for gas to build up in the bottle. So if you have any leftovers, just pour it into a plastic bottle with a screw top lid, put it away in a warm place for 2 to 3 days, and the ginger bug is gonna do all the work. Now this is really important. After you seal your soda, you have to burp your bottle every 8 hours. You see, the ginger bug is eating all the sugar in here, and it's producing carbon dioxide. That's how we get all the little bubbles, but at the same time, gases are forming in here. And if you don't burp your bottle, then too much gas will build up and your bottle might explode when you open it later. And this is how you burp the bottle. It just means you go like this. You open it up to release some of the gas that's been building up, and then you close it again. And that's it. When your soda is nice and bubbly, put it in the fridge to get nice and cold, and this is what it looks like. I love drinking this when I'm outside painting landscapes, and you see all those little bubbles in there? Watch what happens when I pour it. Look how nice and fizzy it gets. Would you believe this soda is actually really good for you? There's tons of probiotics in here that work wonders for your digestive health. And unlike the store-bought ginger ale, this stuff actually tastes like ginger. It's especially good when you're under the weather. I can't stop drinking this. You know, I love sharing recipes and painting pictures for you guys, so if you enjoyed this video, hit your subscribe button and I will see you very soon. Bye!